Well, Baltimore craftsmen played a role in creating the altar the Pope will use to celebrate Mass in Washington, D.C.
They sure did. It took several teams to design, carve, and assemble the finished product. 11 News reporter Carrie Cavanaugh joins us live for an inside look at that intricate process. Hi, Carrie.
Hi, as you can see behind me, the altar is the centerpiece in this stadium-turned-open-air cathedral. Catholic University students actually designed it, but much of the skilled labor took place in Maryland metalworking shops.
The pieces looked more industrial than sacred when they arrived in Baltimore. Four aluminum grates came to Barry Bruce's machine shop on Hall Street to be transformed into an altar fit for Pope Benedict XVI.
I hope that's long enough. Let me see if it's long enough.
Bruce is part of a chain of craftsmen involved in working the parts into a 10-by-4-foot platform upon which the Pope will perform Mass at the new Nationals Park in Washington, D.C.
I'm glad I got the opportunity to do the job. Something that comes along once in a lifetime, and glad I was around to do it.
The pieces were cut with water jets, a 12-hour process before arriving here. Bruce's job is to shear the edges so they'll fit together to form a rectangular base. He spends up to half an hour shaping each side.
Okay. That's what it looks like.
It takes a full day to complete this part of the job, and while the aluminum is light, the work is still demanding.
I just can't hold up this paste. I have to take a break here and there.
That's all right.
Let's hope the Pope likes it. Pope don't like it, what are you going to do?
Greg Campbell of Rockville's Black Rose Forge takes over from here.
We're putting a soft finish with Scotch-Brite pads on the surface of the aluminum grill, which is the face of the altar.
While the faithful assembled to see the Pope won't be close enough to appreciate the perfectly smooth surface, Campbell wants everything to be flawless.
It's been humbling and an honor at the same time.
These renderings reveal the final vision for the papal altar and chair. The Catholic University students who designed the pieces carved the papal coat of arms that will adorn the Holy Father's seat.
But it will be striking with the aluminum on it against the maple.
Meanwhile, Poolsville carpenters pull it all together.
Then there's a 10-inch top that'll come out all the way around. And to be able to do the one that the Holy Father will celebrate the Mass at is going to be an awesome thing.
And an awe-inspiring task that takes an army of artisans to execute. Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.